Yeah. Did you ever go like to King's Dominion or Busch Gardens and they have the thing that says you have to be this tall to ride this ride? Were you always tall enough? No? Sometimes they said, sorry little girl, you're not tall enough, you can't ride this ride. How'd that make you feel? Sad, not so happy. Yeah. Sometimes it feels like we miss out on things. What do you think Jesus would say about that? Well, Jesus would want us to be safe. So the ride thing, and there are certain things we're not supposed to do until we're bigger. But you know what? Jesus would never want us to feel left out. He would always, always want us to be loved. In fact, there's a story in the Bible about that. One day, Jesus and the disciples were out, and Jesus was teaching people. And it was just one of those moments where Jesus was just kind of sitting around. And the little children wanted to come and talk to Jesus. And you know what the disciples said? What do you think, Parker? You're exactly right. They said, no. They said, Jesus is too busy for you little children. Go away, go away. What do you think Jesus said? That they could come. That's exactly what he said. He said, let them come over here. I want to see the kids. What do you think he did with them? He talked to them. I bet he went like this. I bet he tickled them. Found their tickle spot was. He probably told them jokes like, knock, knock. Knock, knock. Orange. Orange, you glad I didn't say it? I don't know the rest of the joke. You know what? You would probably have to ask Jesus the knock knock jokes because, well, he would probably know, wouldn't he? He'd probably be up on the knock knock jokes a lot better than I am. But, that's right. Knock knock, I got it now. Banana. Knock knock. Banana. Knock knock. Orange. Aren't you glad I didn't say banana? Did I get it right that time? All right! There should be applause here. Thank you. See, Jesus wouldn't have missed it like that, would he? But he wanted to talk to the children. He wanted to love them, and he wanted to tell them how very precious they are to him. What does precious mean? Special? What else, Parker? Very, very valuable. Some people talk about precious things in their lives, like, at your grandma's house, is there anything she doesn't let you play with? No? Grandma spoils the living daylights out of you. Everything is up for grabs at grandma's house. I think Jesus would be like that too. But when Jesus said that we are precious, that means that we are valuable to him, and we are, like you said, special. We're special to him. And because of that, you know what? Jesus would always want to be with us. And so today, he wants to be with us just like he did with the children long, long ago. Jesus wants to live in our hearts all the time. And he wants us to know that no matter what happens, no matter who's not there for you, Jesus is always there for you. You remember that? Jesus loves you and he will always, always want you. Okay? You are precious to him. Did you know that? Isn't that precious, Parker? Isn't he a precious boy? Precious Courtney. Yay, let's give God thanks. See how we pray. Dear God, we love you. Thank you for Jesus and how he loves us and always wants us. Thank you that we are precious in his sight. Amen.